A very good morning. These are the headlines. It's Monday morning with me, Katie Gilby. The FTSE 100 marked time as vaccine rollout and hopes of economic recovery were overshadowed by worries that Joe Biden's US stimulus package might falter. London's leading index, it was unmoved at 6,735. That was at the open here in the British capital. The UK is continuing its COVID-19 vaccination at full steam. It said around half of the over 80s have received the jab now. As of today, 5 million people who are over 70 or clinically extremely vulnerable will be invited by letter for a jab. British gas owner Centrica, their chief financial officer Johnathan Ford, he's jumped ship just 7 months after being in that role. The group financial controller Kate Ringrose, she has been appointed as his successor. Virgin Orbit has put its first satellites into space. Richard Branson's firm launched 10 satellites from a rocket under the wing of a 747 plane. Caledonia Mining, their blanket mine in Zimbabwe, produced a record amount of gold in 2020. Production this year is expected to rise again to between 61,000 and 67,000 ounces. While Media IP has acquired the producer royalties of a selection of tracks by Take That. The rights have been acquired from Ian Levine, who is a British songwriter, producer and a DJ. Also today, Farron Pharmaceuticals said the US Department of Defense is the surprise source of funding for a trial to find a treatment for people hospitalized with coronavirus. The DOD will contribute $6.1 million, to the Hippocus study that involves Farron. Lots more details on the website proactiveinvestors.co.uk. You know it by now, and I'll see you tomorrow. Have a great Monday. Goodbye.